Good day, everyone. My name is Mbuso. I'm a BTEC engineering student at NMU. As part of the geometric design module, one is required to analyze an existing intersection and provide improvements regarding pedestrians and bicycles. In this context, I'll look at five-way intersection alignment and elaborate on what's happening there and also what is required in terms of the guidelines. In my introduction, it says, in general, pedestrians and bicycle facilities should be provided anywhere where there is a reasonable expectation that such facility will be used by pedestrians and bicycles, even if the number of pedestrians and bicycles are relatively low. In practice, in South Africa, has a huge number of non-motorized transport and which is, are used for mobility and accessibility purposes. The guideline allows for non-motorized facilities to be provided on four classes of roads. The intersection at Five Ways consists of those four classes of roads, which is Cape Road, which is class 2, mobility function, and it's a major arterial in terms of description. And then we have a road name, which is Albany Road, class 3. The road function is mobility, minor arterial in terms of description. We have Rossbury, which is class 4, mobility, description, it's a collector road. And then we have Parkland, class 5. Road function is access, and then the description is a local street. So we move into the current situation that is happening at the five-way intersection. Currently, there's too many conflicts between pedestrians and bicycles, motorists and bicycles, motorists and pedestrians. If you can see here, you can tell that these conflicts are too high. This is precisely, some of them is precisely because of the current alignment of the road and the intersection itself. This is a multi-legged intersection. It's got five legs out here, out here, out there, out there. And then if you look at the movement here, bicycle movement, lined in green here, it's warranted bicycle movement. And then lined in red is unwarranted bicycle movement. If you look at the unwarranted bicycle movement, first of all, we have to know that the bicycle movement is the bicycle is sharing the roadway with the vehicles, and it's expected that it travels on the left hand side of the roadway when it shares the roadway with the vehicles. But here, within the intersection limit, we've got parking, which is on the left hand side of the road here, on this side on the Cape Road, and also we've got the bus stop on the left hand side of the road, on both directions of Cape Road. This in particular results in a obstruction for the bicycle, because it has to maneuver around the park, the vehicles that are parked here, and also this side of Cape Road. And then this in itself can create a very dangerous situation when they maneuver here. If you look at the cars coming from Rossbury Avenue to turn here, they will conflict with the bicycle here when it turns, when it tries to maneuver on the parking. And then if you also look at here, unwarranted movement of a bicycle, the bicycle might try to take a shortcut here, and regarding into a conflict here with the pedestrians, since this is a pedestrian sidewalk. And also if you look at very close to when regarding to pedestrians, the sidewalk here has no marking and it doesn't show that it's prioritized for pedestrians in itself as a facility. This is one of the things that create problems in this intersection. If you look at more closely here, on the turning of bicycles, the bicycles are supposed to adhere to a pedestrian rules when they get to this intersection here. But you might find that some of the bicycle people, they might want to cut across here, following this red unwarranted movement here, and also here, confronting the oncoming traffic, which can result into a number of dangerous and moves, which can cause accidents. Furthermore, if you look at this intersection, it does not allow for a suitable or comfortable movement of bicycle. It doesn't have markings for bicycles, and it doesn't provide any guidance in terms of bicycle. That is the current situation at the Five Ways intersection. Let's look at how the improvement will impact this intersection going forward. The best practice that is allowable and that can reduce a number of dangerous movements is to provide a separate bicycle lane, which is about 2 meter width on all legs of the intersection on the left hand side of the roadway. These must be separate and must be separated by a marking or a cap on the roadway, and then you must remove the on-street parking that is adjacent to the sidewalk here, and then when it's removed, they must allow for the bicycle lane to travel on the street on a linear form going forward. Removal of a bus stop, also the removal of bus stop here, that is to allow the bicycle lane to be erected here and provide a comfortable movement of high volume of bicycle traffic. And then also provide a bike box here so that the bicycles can cross in front of the vehicle traffic, and also can allow the movement of separate modes from when you look at the pedestrians and the bicycle. That bike box here must be also 2 meters in two meters in all sides, and also must it will guide the bicycles and also provide more safety when it comes to conflict, and provide markings for pedestrians here, and also provide markings for bicycles here, and these will give guidance in terms of movement of both these modes of transport, and also these will also show where a user is allowed to move, or the roadway is allowed for the user to utilize. Provide the pedestrian ramps on the edges here, and on the corner radius here. Pedestrian ramps. These will allow the pedestrians to have a comfortable movement when they about to cross the roadway, and also to cater for disabled people. These will be user friendly, and they will improve their movement, and also allow a quicker movement for crossing the roadway. I thank you.